So why is AI so important? Why are people so excited about what's coming down the path with regards to AI? The answer is because the thing for which AI drops the cost is such a foundational input. It's everywhere. What is that thing? Prediction. AI drops the cost of prediction. That's what it does. So, when the cost of prediction falls, just like arithmetic, two things happen. First of all, the activities for which prediction is an input become cheaper, because prediction's cheaper. So demand forecasting, inventory management, all of those types of things become cheaper, faster, better, because we've got a new technology that will deliver those things in a more effective way. But also, when prediction becomes cheap, we'll start using it to solve problems that weren't traditionally prediction problems. That's where AI enters industries that we don't think of as being AI-oriented. Let me give you an example. We'll start using prediction to solve problems that weren't traditionally prediction problems, like driving. So we've had autonomous vehicles for a very long time. But the way that we've done it is that the engineers who design these things have a floor plan, and they program the robot to drive around a factory floor or a warehouse. And so the robot drives around, they can program, they know where the shelves are, they know where the aisles are, and they program it to move around, and then they give it some intelligence. They put a camera on the robot, and they give it some logic, like if-then-else logic. They'll say, if a human walks in front of the robot, then stop. If the shelf is empty, then go to the next shelf. Okay, that gives the robot a little bit of intelligence. So we've had basic intelligence in autonomous vehicles for some time. But you could never put that vehicle on a city street. And the reason is because there's an infinite number of if-thens. If it's raining, if it's dark, if a child runs across the street, if a dog approaches the crosswalk, if a car's coming with its left blinker on, all the ifs means that there's effectively an infinite number of possibilities. You could never write down all the logic. That's why all of the experts have said, this is an intractable problem. We won't have an autonomous vehicle on a city street for another 30 years at least. That's why, because of the if-then problem. That was true until they recast this as a prediction problem. And they changed it into a single focus prediction problem. And the prediction became, what would a human do? That's the prediction. So the way you can think about it is they put a human in a car, and they tell the human to drive. And you can imagine that the way that they've done this is putting an AI in the car beside the human. Now when we drive, here's what happens. As we're driving, we get data that comes in through the cameras on the front of our head and the microphones on the side of our head. That's the data that comes in. Then we process the data with our monkey brains, and then we take an action. And the actions are very simple. We can turn left, turn right, brake, or accelerate. That's it. Data in, process, action out. That's all we do. Now imagine the AI sitting in the car with us. The AI doesn't get our data input, so it has to have its own data input. And we do that with cameras, radar, LiDAR. All of those sensors are providing data in. As the data comes in, every second the data is coming in, the AI looks over to the human and tries to predict, okay, what will the human do in the next 1 second? So this is what the data I'm getting right now. What's the human about to do driving? Data in, turn right. This data happens, keep going. This data happens, step on the brake. Every time it's trying to predict, what will the human driver do? And as it goes, it makes a lot of mistakes in the early predictions. It doesn't matter, it's just watching and predicting. But as it watches the driving, the predictions get better and better and better. And the confidence intervals on those predictions get smaller and smaller and smaller. until it's such a good predictor that we say, you can just drive by yourself. Hey, you can drive by yourself because you pretty much can perfectly predict what a human would do if they were behind the wheel. And by the way, not just an average human, not a human that might have had a drink, that might be texting, that might be doing other things, that might be angry because of an argument they just had before they climbed in the car. You can predict what an excellent human driver, the best human drivers would do.